Alright, so this video is kind of I don't know. It's more to the young, I guess. Like, when I was growing up, all throughout my childhood, my brothers and I, we wrote letters all the time, all the time. We wrote letters to each other, we wrote letters to our mother, our father, we wrote letters to our grandparents. So and I think it's a habit that we don't do any longer. I don't believe it's something that is done. I think we've gone out of the fashion of it. And I believe to build, what do we call it, the curriculum and the brain, that it's like the creative writing gumption, you know, to get back into authoring and all of this. It starts there. There's a stir there in the very beginning, you know, when you have the practice again and again. With the pen. So anyway, I'll read this brief letter. This is when I was in Manhattan, actually. Here's the letter, the photo. So I was in Manhattan. I was living there. Okay. And I sent them. It says, "Grandma and Grandpa, I miss you so much. There are so many people in New York, but none could ever replace you two. You are truly special grandparents, and I'm proud to be a part of your offspring. Grandma, take some free time to remember how great you are. Grandpa, take an aerobic or dance class at the Y. You would have fun. It's good for you to take some time away from the house. P.S. I live on the left side, right near the park. It's really beautiful." So in this letter, it's the left side. "I love you guys always. Thanks for being you. Love, Teresa." All right, so here I am. I'm saying this, you know, and I'm like, well, it's kind of like gushy in a way that I would even be writing that much, you know. And then I'm thinking, well, maybe it's not cool. Maybe that's what happens, you know. It's not cool to write your grandparents. But I think it's a very important facet in our growth as human beings, you know. So anyway, thanks for being you, you know, and I really hope that you know, those types of sentiments, you know, it surpasses a ridiculous Hallmark type of card that's already been pre-written. It surpasses it, you know. And sometimes in sentiment, when it's your own hand, your own right, your own actual endeavor, it has a higher meaning, you know, much higher meaning. And I don't know, maybe it was the 60s group that was really pushy with all of it. Lovey-dovey, lovey-dovey all the time, you know, here, there, whatever. You know, you're just the most fabulous. Maybe the 70s, in the 80s, maybe we were just writing these things all the time as children. I'm not sure if that's going on any longer. And if it isn't, it's kind of a shame, because grandparents, they really are supposed to just be innocents. Just like the young children, they're just supposed to be innocents, treated from grandchild to grandparent. It's like an innocent relationship. So yeah, it's kind of an interesting thing that we need to foster, and what do we call it? Procreate into the future. It has to be something brought into the future, that we remember to have these simple, innocent, you know, what do you call it? It's not really, you know, and there's a letter, you know, it just arrives in the mail. The letter arrives in the mail, the postal mail, and there's my grandmother receiving it. There's my grandfather, and they're not doing anything. Except there it is, you know. What did you get today? We got a letter from Teresa. That's it. We got a letter. And it's wonderful. You know? To go your life and not get a letter from your granddaughter. To go your life and not get a letter from your grandson. Would be an odd life, wouldn't it? So anyway, and even here, yeah, I'm a little aggressive telling him to go to the Y, I know, to go to aerobics class, but that's the way I am a little bit sometimes, a little pushy. But yeah, I guess so. I lived on the left side of Manhattan. And this one, I believe that's on, what is it, the east or the west? I think it's on the west. Yeah, it's on the west side. Yeah. So anyway, cute. Alrighty. Yeah, so maybe that's something, you know, for teachers out there who want to teach their children, their students, you know, even at class, even if you do that in school, that's something to bring into school, is to bring, hey, we're going to write to our grandparents today, or we're going to write to, you know, some guardian. You know, just tell them thank you in pure, honest sentiment from the heart. All right.